Vitamin K plays a key role in helping the blood clot, preventing excessive bleeding. Unlike many other vitamins, vitamin K is not typically used as a dietary supplement. In this video, let's find found. What is menaquinone? What is menaquinone used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking menaquinone? How does menaquinone work? How to use menaquinone? What is menaquinone? Vitamin K2 or menaquinone is one of three types of vitamin K, the other two being vitamin K and K3. K2 is both a tissue and bacterial product and is usually found in animal products or fermented foods. When there are no isoprenyl side chain units, the raw molecule is vitamin K3. This is usually made synthetically and is used in animal feed. It was formerly given to premature infants, but due to inadvertent toxicity in the form of hemolytic anemia and jaundice, it is no longer used for this purpose. K3 is now known to be a circulating intermediate animal production of negative 4 Malawian kwachas. What is menaquinone used for? Recently, some people have looked to vitamin K2 to treat osteoporosis and steroid-induced bone loss, but the research is conflicting. At this point, there is not enough data to recommend using vitamin K2 for osteoporosis. Contraindication. There are no severe adverse effects due to the supplementation of vitamin K2-7. However, high doses of vitamin K2 can cause allergic reactions. What is menaquinone used for? Recently, some people have looked to vitamin K2 to treat osteoporosis and steroid-induced bone loss, but the research is conflicting. At this point, there is not enough data to recommend using vitamin K2 for osteoporosis. Contraindication. There are no severe adverse effects due to the supplementation of vitamin K2-7. However, high doses of vitamin K2 can cause allergic reactions. What is menaquinone used for? Recently, some people have looked to vitamin K2 to treat osteoporosis and steroid-induced bone loss, but the research is conflicting. At this point, there is not enough data to recommend using vitamin K2 for osteoporosis. Half-life. In fact, since vitamin K2 has a half-life of more than 3 days and is redistributed in the circulatory system via VLDL and LDL cholesterol, making it available to bone, vasculature, and liver tissues, daily intakes of 45 micrograms of vitamin K2 means no extra supplemental K1 is needed. Dose. Group. Adequate intake. Children 0 to 6 months. 2 micrograms / day. Children 7 to 12 months. 2.5 micrograms / day. Children 1 to 3. 30 micrograms / day. Children 4 to 8. 55 micrograms / day. Children 9 to 13. 60 micrograms / day. Girls 14 to 18. 75 micrograms / day. Women 19 and up. 90 micrograms / day. Women, pregnant or breastfeeding, 19 to 50. 90 micrograms / day. Women, pregnant or breastfeeding, under 19. 75 micrograms / day. Boys 14 to 18. 75 micrograms / day. Men 19 and up. 120 micrograms / day. Safety advice. Vitamin K has not been reported to cause birth defects or other problems in humans. Dose. Group. Adequate intake. Children 0 to 6 months. 2 micrograms / day. Children 7 to 12 months. 2.5 micrograms / day. Children 1 to 3. 30 micrograms / day. Children 4 to 8. 55 micrograms / day. Children 9 to 13. 60 micrograms / day. Girls 14 to 18. 75 micrograms / day. Women 19 and up. 90 micrograms / day. women, pregnant or breastfeeding, 19 to 50. 90 micrograms slash day. Women, pregnant or breastfeeding, under 19. 75 micrograms slash day. Boys 14 to 18. 75 micrograms slash day. Men 19 and up. 120 micrograms slash day.